Today we rule our planet, but there was a time, even before we existed, when creatures much more dangerous roamed Earth. From the famous T-Rex to the gigantic Alarmosaurus, join us as we go back in time to look at 10 terrifying dinosaurs from the Cretaceous period.
Number 10.
Tyrannosaurus Rex. What better way to kick off our list than to mention perhaps the most popular dinosaur, made famous partly by Steven Spielberg's Jurassic Park in 1993. Tyrannosaurus Rex, or T-Rex as it's better known, ruled North America during the late Cretaceous period around 65 million years ago. The massive skull of this mighty theropod dinosaur measured 1.5 meters and was balanced by a long, heavy tail. The jaw, filled with huge, saw-edged teeth, could deliver a devastating bite, in fact, one of the most powerful bites of any known dinosaur. While some debate if T-Rex was a hunter or a scavenger, one thing's for sure, you wouldn't want to mess with one.
Number 9.
Velociraptor. Velociraptor roamed the Earth about 85.8 to 70.6 million years ago, during the end of the Cretaceous period. It is another dinosaur made famous by Jurassic Park. Sadly, however, that fame was built on a lie. Jurassic Park special effects wizards have long since confessed that they modeled their Velociraptor after the much bigger and much more dangerous looking raptor Deinonychus, whose name isn't quite as catchy or as easy to pronounce. Although its sharp teeth and clutching hands were certainly unpleasant, the primary weapons in Velociraptor's arsenal were the curved, 3-inch long claws on its hind feet, which it used to slash and jab at prey. Paleontologists believe that this dinosaur stabbed its prey in the gut in sudden surprise attacks, then withdrew to a safe distance as its victim bled to death.
Number 8.
Spinosaurus. Spinosaurus was the biggest of all the carnivorous dinosaurs, larger even than Tyrannosaurus and Gigantosaurus. But it's unclear just how big Spinosaurus was due to incomplete fossils. It lived during part of the Cretaceous period, about 112 to 97 million years ago, roaming the swamps of North Africa. Spinosaurus means spine lizard, an appropriate name as the dinosaur had very long spines growing on its back from what is referred to as a sail. The distinctive spines which grew out of the animal's back vertebrae were up to 7 feet long and were likely connected to one another by skin.
Number 7.
Ankylosaurus. Ankylosaurus was a huge armored dinosaur, measuring about 25 to 35 feet long, 6 feet wide and 4 feet tall. It weighed roughly 3 to 4 tons. Its entire top side was heavily protected from carnivores with thick, oval plates embedded in its leathery skin, 2 rows of spikes along its body, large horns that projected from the back of the head, and a club-like tail. It even had bony plates as protection for its eyes. Only under its belly was it unplated. Flipping it over was probably the only way to wound it.
Number 6.
Triceratops. Triceratops was a rhinoceros-like dinosaur. It walked on 4 sturdy legs and had 3 horns on its face along with a large bony plate projecting from the back of its skull. It had 1 short horn above its parrot-like beak and 2 longer horns, over 3 feet long, above its eyes that provided protection from predators. The horns were possibly also used in mating rivalry and rituals. It had a very large skull, up to 10 feet long, one of the largest skulls of any land animal ever discovered. Its head was nearly 1/3 as long as its body.
Number 5.
Alarmosaurus. Alarmosaurus is one of the few titanosaurs known to have lived in the late Cretaceous in North America, and possibly in vast numbers. According to one analyst, there may have been as many as 350,000 of these 60-foot-long herbivores living in Texas at any given time. A recent analysis has shown that Alarmosaurus may have been a bigger dinosaur than originally estimated, possibly in the weight class of its more famous South American cousin, Argentinosaurus. It turns out that some of the type fossils used to reconstruct Alarmosaurus may have come from adolescents rather than full-grown adults, meaning that this titanosaur may well have attained lengths of over 60 feet from head to tail and weights in excess of 70 or 80 tons.
Number 4.
Carcharodontosaurus. Carcharodontosaurus is named after its long, sharp teeth with their deadly serrations. It is also known as the shark-toothed or jagged-toothed lizard. Its teeth would have slashed through flesh with ease, making it one of the most feared and successful meat-eating dinosaurs of North America. It was also one of the longest and heaviest, being slightly larger than North America's Tyrannosaurus rex, although its brain was probably smaller. Two teeth were first identified in Algeria in 1927, and more findings followed in the 1990s. It is highly likely that Carcharodontosaurus would have come into conflict with the largest carnivorous dinosaur of all time, Spinosaurus. This would have been a battle of epic proportions, and one you definitely wouldn't want to be caught in the middle of.
Number 3.
Troodon. Troodon is a small bird-like theropod. It has very long legs with specialized feet, in which the middle long bone was pinched out at the top to form a shock-absorbing wedge. This allowed it to run very fast. Troodon had very large eyes that faced mostly forward so that it could focus better. It is famous for having one of the largest brains, for its body size, of any dinosaur, making it the most intelligent. Troodon had a jaw full of many small teeth, but they were not like the teeth of typical meat-eaters. Instead of little serrations running up and down the back of the teeth, as in most meat-eaters, there were much bigger bumps running along the side, as in many plant-eating dinosaurs and lizards. Some paleontologists speculate that Troodon may have eaten not only small animals, lizards and baby dinosaurs, but also insects, eggs, and even plants.
Number 2.
Megaraptor. Okay, to be honest, I only included this in the list so I could say Megaraptor. So, Megaraptor. Okay, now that that's out of the way, Megaraptor was a large, terrifying late Cretaceous predator with two enormous sickle-like toe claws. It was a huge, lightly built, fast-moving, agile, bipedal, bird-like dinosaur. It had a curved, flexible neck and a big head with sharp, serrated teeth and very powerful jaws. The second toe on each foot had a 14-inch sickle-like claw, and the other toes had smaller claws. When alive, this claw would have been sheathed in a horny, keratinous material, much like our fingernails, making the claws even bigger, longer, and sharper. The tail was probably used for balance and fast turning. Megaraptor was about 20 to 26 feet long, and would have easily had us for lunch.
Number 1.
Kronosaurus. Kronosaurus was a classic example of a pliosaur. Marine reptiles characterized by their thick heads, short necks, stocky trunks, and outsized flippers. Kronosaurus is one of the more famous fossil discoveries to come from Australia, and as a huge short-necked pliosaur, Kronosaurus would have been an apex predator of the waters it swam in. The teeth of Kronosaurus are conical and up to 30 centimeters long. Initial size estimates for Kronosaurus placed it at just under 13 meters long. However, further study combined with a better understanding of pliosaur remains in general resulted in a reduction in this estimate to somewhere in the region of 9 to 10 meters long. Regardless, you wouldn't exactly want to go around swimming with one now, would you?